Most programming languages include basic data types. Ahmad is describing the basic data types he has used. State the type that Ahmad is describing in each sentence. Choose the data type from this list of programming terms. Here we have a list of programming terms, and we have a number of statements. We have to choose which programming term fits with the statements. The first thing to notice about this question is that for every answer, they want us to give a data type. So we can go through each of these programming terms and highlight the data types. That will reduce the set of possible answers we can choose from and make this question easier to answer. Let's start off with an array. An array is not actually a data type. It is a data structure that is made up of multiple elements of the same data type, but it is not known as a data type. So we're not going to highlight this. A Boolean we've discussed before is a data type. This can either be true or false. A char or a character is a data type we've discussed before. This is a single character, usually from the ASCII table or from Unicode. A constant is not a data type. A constant is used in programming to store a single value and doesn't change during the execution of the program. A function is also not a data type. A function is a self-contained module of code that accomplishes a specific task within your program. An integer we've discussed before is a data type. An integer can be a whole number that is either negative or positive. Iteration is not a data type. This is the process of running a section of code and then looping back to the beginning to run that section of code again, a number of times. A procedure is not a data type. This is similar to a function, except that a procedure does not return a value. A real number is also a data type we've discussed before. This is a number that has a fractional part or a decimal number that contains all integer values. A string is also a data type we've discussed before. This is a sequence of characters. And a variable is not a data type. This is similar to a constant, except that the variable can be changed during the execution of the program. Now let's go through each of these descriptions and match the data types. The first one says, a number with a fractional part that can be positive or negative and used in calculations. We have two different number data types, a real number and an integer. The difference between an integer and a real number is that real numbers can contain fractional parts, whereas integers can only be whole numbers. So let's go ahead and write in real. The next one says, a whole number that can be positive, negative, or zero and used in calculations. This is going to be our other number data type, the integer. Let's write that in. The next one says, a single number, symbol, or letter. We have three data types left, a Boolean, character, and string. A Boolean is a value that can either be true or false. A string is a sequence of characters, so a character must be a single number, symbol, or letter. Let's fill in char. The next one, a sequence of characters. We've mentioned that this is a string. And finally, a data type with two values, true or false. This is going to be the Boolean. And there we go. That is this question complete.